Okay, I hope we had a good break just to have you. So now, as we said, let's just, have a quick recap. Thank you, Mr. iPad, for making such a break. Okay, let me just have a water. So again, as I said, if you were able to know the question is testing you in which phase, is it in the initiation, is it in the planning, you have already solved 50% of the question. Okay, so the remaining half we will cover it, inshallah, in the upcoming session and in the upcoming sessions, inshallah, from lecture 3 all the way to lecture 7. So let us see how we will be able to see that. So let me just show you the game. So this is gonna be our ultimate goal. Okay, how we will be able to rectify our understanding of what's gonna happen in the initiation, what's gonna happen in the planning, what's gonna happen in the execution through our game. So inshallah, we'll play this together, inshallah, 2 days after. So inshallah, this is gonna be our task for Wednesday evening. We'll play this game together on Wednesday evening. So I'm giving you tonight, tomorrow, and Wednesday to go over the material. So the moment we go over Wednesday night, we'll be able to play this together. Now you can have it yourself. I recommend you to play this game. So as you can see here, I have the five columns. I have my initiation, planning, execution, monitoring, controlling, and what? Closing. Okay? And I have here how many? I have here 92 cards, 92 checkpoints. So check yourself right now. Just after we finish the lecture, see yourself. How crabby is your mindset in terms of PMP? See if you read this, for example, when you read this one. Acquire final team and physical resources. When I am doing this activity, when I am acquiring my final team and physical resources. So some of you will say, acquiring final team and physical resources, this is happening in the closing because he saw final team. He thought, oh, final means in the closing. Okay, so that's what he will do. He will just put it simply where he will take it to the closing, and you'll find the nice incorrect. So if you found your corruption, it's not happening in the closing phase. It's happening where? It's happening in the execution. Then you go again to the manage reserve. When manage reserve is happening, I know some of you will say, Muhammad, reserves are Chinese. Okay, that's why we have this lecture, to try to minimize the amount of Chinese words you are gonna encounter when you play the game. Okay, so make sure you have your water, your bison, whatever you have, so we can help you decrease the amount of Chinese words you are gonna encounter. Okay, so this just to help you have an insight. So this is gonna be the milestone that we want to achieve from the second milestone of our agenda, which is the project management processes. We have covered in the first part what? The project management life cycle. When we do this task, we are having a clear understanding of what? The project management processes. Or let's say the project management process groups. Because now I care about what? Putting these 92 cards in the right column. Okay, so ask yourself for each one of these cards, this is happening when? In initiation, in planning, in execution, or in closing. So just go ahead and do it. We'll not do the game right now. We'll do it, inshallah, and what? On Wednesday night, inshallah. So now, what we will do from now until the end of the session? We will try our best. Inshallah, God will help me to make it more exciting to you. We are going to try our best to minimize the amount of Chinese words you are going to encounter when you study the homework. Okay? Agree? So try to capture as much as you can from the things that we are going to discuss right now. And don't worry, I'm going to explain this from where? From our PMP story. Okay, so we are gonna try to understand what I am doing as a project manager in the initiation, what I am doing as a project manager in the planning and the execution, utilizing my PMP story. So now, just sit. I'll just give you 4 to 5 seconds just to, shake your head, make sure that you focus on the things that we are gonna cover right now. Make sure your mind is with me. your heart is also with me, because whatever we are gonna cover right now is gonna be the heart of your studying. I'm trying to use a very strong word to make you focus. Okay, so let's just go ahead to our famous PMP story. So let's go back to what our PMP story. Here we go. Here is our PMP story. So let's now understand our product, okay? Let's just have an understanding of our PMP journey, okay? And try to understand what's being covered in the initiation, planning, execution, in a story approach. I don't, Muhammad, to memorize. I want to understand, okay? So can you please help me understand this in a story approach so I enjoy studying PMP with you? It's my pleasure. But please focus. Okay. Now, many of you, or let's say before saying many of you, okay, let us just make sure that we have an agreement on the borders. I was always telling you that the initiation is this one, right? This was the fact, right? No. This is I was always telling you that this is the initiation. However, this is not the initiation phase. I was just putting this just to make it clear to you. Now is the time to go for two more details. So our initiation is not really this. Our initiation is just only this part. Everything that is happening before this is outside the scope of PMP. Okay? So does that mean we'll not study it? No, we will study it. Why? Because we need to understand the story from the zero, okay? I don't want to go ahead and watch the second season. I want to see the first season so I can make a complete story, okay? That's why I believe one of the major issues we face with PMP is that we don't study the part before the initiation. That's why it's like we start our PMP journey with chapter 2, while we are supposed to start with chapter 0. So we can make a complete story, a comprehensive story that we can explain with confidence to somebody else. Okay? Just to help you understand that this phase or this part that's occurring before the initiation phase, it is the job of whom? The BA. The business analyst. In Arabic, محلل الأعمال. محلل الأعمال هو الشخص اللي يساعد the project manager after the initiation. محلل الأعمال means business analysis. Okay? So we have a specific certification for this, which is our PMI PBA, which is the professional in business analysis. This is the guy who is studying the visibility, which is taking place what? In this area. As I said, okay. For the remaining part, it's the same. This is the planning. This is our execution. This is our monitoring, controlling, and this is our closing. So now, gentlemen, let's agree on one thing. Let's now start with what from that part. That's occurring before what? Before the initiation, okay? Because this will help us, have a clear understanding of the PMP story as a whole, okay? What is happening before the initiation? Why our project got started? Why? I have a guy who's sitting there and say, Muhammad, I have a problem. I have a problem and I want a solution, okay? So the first thing is that my solution is gonna be a solution to his problem. But the question is, do I know his real problem? Maybe when I have my customer, so I'm a bad guy. So let's say I have here the customer who said, okay, please help. Help me. I have an issue. Okay. So when you go there as the BA, so I'll draw the BA over here. Okay. So here is your BA. This we call him what? The BA, which is محلل الأعمال. Okay. He will go to this guy. What's your issue? This guy, he will start describing his issue at the surface level. Don't be stupid as a BA and solve this surface issue. You need to do root cause analysis. You need to understand the real problem. Okay? The moment you know the real problem, then you need to go ahead and advise of the possible solutions that are there to solve the real problem. Okay, and by the way, I'm using my course, my 7-week program, to fulfill the real need with the many of the people who are taking the PMP exam. So in our PMP story, we are going to apply, we are going to see how is Muhammad al-Shah program is really following the PMP story. Okay, so for example, you are now a person who is really want to take your PMP certification. But you say, Muhammad, the current courses are spoon feeding. 5 days are not enough. That's why now I know your problem is that you are a person who's not committed. You are a person who's, you know, have a problem with your time management. You are a problem who's not having the discipline. That's why what I'm doing in my program, I'm trying to fulfill the need you have as a customer. Okay. I'm trying to have a program of 7 weeks to help you have the discipline. So I'm trying to solve the root cause of your problem as a customer. And that's why you will find my product is really helpful. That's why you enjoy it. Okay. So again, any project starts with a problem. If you don't have a problem to solve, then you don't have a project. So you need to first see what's the problem. Okay. The moment you see the problem, go and do root cause analysis to know the real problem. The moment you have understanding of the real problem, then you start, you know, meeting those stakeholders. As a BA, you sit with the stakeholders. Okay, guys, we have this real problem. Can you help us, please? We need to find solutions for this problem. Because again, as a BA, I am the guy who's just, you know, trying to help the customer find a solution for his problem. So I'm going to have a couple of stakeholders who will be with me to what? To find a solution to this meskeen person, to this guy, okay? So I'm just, you know, coming up with what? If you go here, again, I hope now it's going to be working quickly, alhamdulillah. So now, when I find the real problem, which I call it the business need, okay? So my real problem is what? My business need, okay? Then I will go ahead and find different proposals, okay? Different cases that can be there to fulfill the need the customer has. Not any need, the real need, okay? After I go with my stakeholders and I define a couple of people over there, a couple of solutions, I will have that kind of filter to help me, you know, see which one of those proposals will have the highest benefit and the lowest cost. And this will be what? My proposed solution, which we call it what? The business case. So the job of the BA is to go and analyze the business need and come up with the business case. So the BA, he's gonna develop two major milestones over here. He is gonna build the business case and what? The benefit management plan. Again, two things. The business case and the benefit management plan, which is there to help you have a plan in place for the benefits. For the benefits I'm gonna realize later on in my project. Be careful when you see business need and business case. Business need is a problem. Business case is a solution to that problem. Okay? And it's not any solution. It is my filtered. So here is I have my filter. So after conducting cost-benefit analysis of these, I came up with what? With my business case. Okay? That will be what? An input to my initiation phase. That's why when you go ahead to your what? To your project charter process, which we will cover inshallah next week, okay? One of the inputs is what? The business case. The other input is what? The benefit management plan that were developed by whom? The person who's outside your project, that's called the BA. Again, you could be the BA and the PM at the same time. But you know, the moment the sponsor authorized you by signing the charter, your rules and responsibilities has been converted from being a BA to a PM. So the BA and the PM could be the same person, by the way. It's only different roles and responsibilities. It's just for you to understand that the BA responsibility is to convert that business need to business case. The moment I feed that business case to my develop project charter process, I am now authorizing formally the project. I am as a sponsor funding my project in the charter, okay? And again, I am also what identifying my stakeholders. If you recall over here, the guy who said, please help us, the guy. Yes, we call this guy, the one highlighted here. This is a stakeholder, okay? Come on, this is not a highlighter. Then we call this maskeen, this guy is a stakeholder, okay? Who's saying help, help. So this is one of the first people who are identified as a stakeholder. And those people who have proposed to me the solutions are also stakeholders, okay? That's why I have a formal process called what? In the beginning, it is called what? Identify stakeholders. So I'm identifying those people who are initiating the need, and those who are impacted by the proposed solution. So I am just putting all of them together and putting them in something called what? This is just for your information. We'll cover it later on. We put it what? The risk, the stakeholder register. So again, if I have my initiation, so the main milestones I have from my initiation is what? The charter. Project charter, which is going to authorize the project, that is going to fund the project the moment it is signed, and it is going to authorize the project manager. What else we have over here? We have our stakeholder register. That is going to include all the information that we have about the stakeholder. Don't worry, okay? We'll cover this in more details later on. Okay, so at the moment you should understand this is the key milestones we are getting from our initiation stage. We are having our project funded because we have already convinced the sponsor. We have this benefit. Okay, we have the stakeholders. So now we have already have an understanding in mind. What is happening in the initiation? In the initiation, I have my business case. I am just trying to have a high level understanding of my project. Okay, what is the constraints I have? What is the culture of my company? What is everything? And when you go into your reading assignment, you'll have more understanding of what's being covered in the initiation. But just keep in mind that the initiation phase is mainly there to initiate the project, to have your project funded, and you have a list of stakeholders that you have identified. Okay, now, the first thing that you, the moment you have your project initiated, now you have what? The green light to start with what? With your planning, right? Now is the time to reduce the amount of uncertainty. I don't want to execute. Some of you will say, Muhammad, why can't I enter my execution phase directly? Well, you have a lot of uncertainty at the moment. The charter is not sufficient enough for you to go ahead with your execution. So that's why you have your planning there, to reduce the uncertainty you have. That's why you have 24 processes that are there to reduce the uncertainty. And these are the same as what we have covered so far in our PMP story, okay? So if we go over here, so we start now in our planning phase over here. Since we have already the green light, we are trying to reduce the uncertainty as much as we can. So by the end, of what? By the end of our planning, we have our uncertainty here at the minimum. So I can execute without doing any rework. Okay? So let's just go quickly and cover our planning activities. Put in mind very important thing when it comes to the planning. And you'll find this also there. Can you see this here? Planning. This is the only process group with a set order, but 1,000 lines under this. It is the only process group that need you to know it in order. So I need to know that this happened before this, before this, before this. So the sequence matters. That's why when you do your homework and you do the RITA game, after you place all the items in the right column, the last task you will do is to place the items in the planning column in the right order. So we need to really understand that I cannot estimate my resources unless I develop my scope and activities first. I cannot do my risk management activities unless I estimate my resources and costs and durations. So the order is a must. I cannot really start with risk management unless I do those subsequent activities. Same with this here. I should really start with the initiation processes. I need to identify my stakeholders before I define my scope. I cannot define my scope from scratch. I need my stakeholders to help me develop my scope. Okay? So we'll see the orders and sequence by the end of the session. Now let's just have a high-level understanding of the activities that are covered in the planning. And it's going to be quick because we have already studied this when we went through the PMP story. Okay? So let's just go ahead and just, you know, have a very quick, you know, review of the activities that is happening in the execution and the planning processes. So we start, let me just have it in green. So we start first of all with our scope management board. So this is our scope. So we start this first of all by collecting the requirements. So we have already identified our stakeholders. So it's the time now to convert all the wish list, all the constraints, all the assumptions, all the desires into requirements. I need to convert everything I have into requirements, okay? The moment I have the requirements, then I will go ahead and filter these requirements to what? To my scope, because I have already my charter. So my charter will help me filter those requirements to have my scope, into which I will say, okay, I will do 1, 2, 3, 4, and I will not do 5, 6, and 7, and 8. And after that, I will come, the moment I have my scope statement, I will break this down to what? To the manageable pieces called the work packages, okay? The moment I have my work packages, now is the time to do more decomposition and define all those work packages, decompose them also to what? To the activities required to complete the work packages. The moment I define the activities, now is the time to sequence the activities and put the logical sequence. Okay? So the moment I have my defined activities, then I have what? The sequence, the activities process. Okay? So when I do this, now I have a logical understanding of the complexity of my scope. So I can really now estimate the qualification required for my resources and the quantity I need. So I'll go ahead and estimate my resources. The moment I estimate my resources, based on the complexity I have, now I can really judge how much I need to complete that activity. What's the duration? 5 days, 10 days, depending on the what? The expertise level of my resources. So I can now come up with the durations. The moment I have the durations, I will go with what? With my cost. Okay? The moment I have my cost, then I need to have a balance between my resources, durations, and cost, okay? Depending on the priority of the project. As a result, I will come up with my schedule, then I will have my budget, in which I will see what's my funding limits, because I'm taking loans from the banks, so I need to make sure that the fund is coming at the right time as per the schedule. If the fund is not available, then I need to expand my schedule to be available when the fund is available, okay? After that, I will go to the iteration. I will go to my risk management, okay? And as I said before, we have iterative processes, which means I will revisit the estimation processes but through what? The risk management. Can you see here where the iterative came into place? Do you recall the project life cycle when we said iterative? It means I will reuse the activities and again until I have a realistic plan. Okay? So that's why the moment I went to risk management, I am trying to put contingency reserves. In Arabic, احتياطات. It means when I have, you know, my estimate, I'm putting احتياطات. I'm putting reserve to make my estimate realistic. That's why risk management is important, to make my estimates, my plans more realistic. Okay? The moment I have risk management, I will go ahead with what? With my refined baselines. خلاص, I have already my contingency reserves, so I have now affirmed baselines. After that, I will go ahead and sit with my stakeholders, okay? To just have the agreement, okay, have approval. The moment I have the approval, I will do what? خلاص, I will sign the project management plan. So this will be the period where after that, change management procedure will occur. Before that, no change management procedure is required, okay? And here is the main difference between the plan-driven approach and the change-driven approach. In the plan-driven approach, you don't want changes. That's why you put a very detailed procedure to control the changes in your project. While in the agile project, you want to make your customer happy. So you are welcoming changes anyway. But this is not the scope of our lecture, because this, inshallah, in my upcoming lectures in PMP, if I'm going to teach PMP, inshallah, after July. Okay? So I'm not going to teach you anything about agile at the moment, because I know you are after PMP. Before July, okay? So the moment we have an approved plan, then now I have already an approved plan. Now I'm ready to go to what? To my execution, okay? So I have already now understand. By the end of my planning, after I have collected the requirements and defined my scope, I created the WBS and estimate my, define my activities and I sequence them, then the resources, then blah, 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 all the way to risk management. Now I have done sufficient activities that are there to reduce the uncertainty. So now I can go ahead and start converting the theory to actuals. It's now the time to implement the plans and come up with what? Let me just remove this. Come up with what? My deliverables, my actuals. Okay? So again, the execution activities, this is what you are doing as a project manager. In the execution phase, you take your plan and you try to implement your plans as per the plan. Okay, so I have my deliverables, okay? My deliverables, you know, will have a couple of things. For example, I have some procurement to take place in the execution phase. I need to sit with my contractors to make sure they understand the scope of work before awarding it to them, okay? So all of these details about the contracts will cover it, inshallah, in what? When we talk about procurement management. But now it's very important that you understand my procurement activities. What are those parts that are covered in the planning phase? What are those parts of the procurement that are happening in the execution? What is the part of procurement that's occurring in the monitoring control? This is what I want you to focus at when you do your homework. Just try to have the basic understanding. How procurement is being done in the planning, how it's being done in the execution, and how it's being done in what? And the monitoring control. When I talk about my request for quotation, RFQ, or request for invitation, am I doing this in the planning or execution? When I'm sitting with my bidders and have discussion, the technical clarification and this kind of stuff, when this is happening, planning, execution, monitoring control, when I'm closing my procurement, when this is happening, I will not answer you. You can find this in your homework. Inshallah, we'll cover this more, inshallah, on our Wednesday. I'm just raising questions that you should really ask, you know, because again, whatever you're going to cover here, it's really what you are doing, gentlemen. So don't be overwhelmed. Just enjoy what you are doing right now, because you are now having a solid limit between what you are doing in the execution to whatever you are doing in the monitoring control. Okay? Some of you will ask, okay, Muhammad, why can't I just, you know, produce a deliverable and go ahead to my closing? Why I need to go to my monitoring controlling? Because I want to check how healthy I'm executing my project. Am I conforming to the plans? Verification. Am I producing a solution that is fulfilling the business need? Validation. Do you remember in our discussion? We have two checkpoints, verification and validation. So verification and validation, these are two items that are part of your project, of your monitoring and controlling phase. So we have already cleared two cards of the 92 cards that you are going to do in what? In your game, in your retail game. Okay? So in the monitoring and controlling, again, all what I am doing over there is that I'm trying to make sure that my deliverables is confirming to my plans as well as to my business need. The moment everything is good, then I will go ahead with what? With my final product, which is what? The closing phase. Also, I need to understand as a project manager, what are the different activities I'm doing in the closing? I can come to you now and give you the details you want. I have already the knowledge. But I don't want to make the session boring. And I don't want, I respect your time. I don't want to take that much time from you. Okay? You have my Snapchat. Again, I told you before that we have a Snapchat over there. It is there to have that kind. So, sorry. Let me just, this is the main issue when I talk. This is the main purpose of having Snapchat, to have stakeholder engagement throughout the week. I don't want, you know, just to answer your questions in the live session. You have your mobile phone with you all the time. So please, for those who have not yet added me in Snapchat, please do so. Any questions you have, just go ahead and send it to my Snapchat. And I'll be glad to answer you directly. Tell me, Muhammad, I don't understand why this item is happening in the closing. I used to do it in the planning. This B&B is not good. I don't want to take it. خلاص, مع السلامة. No. Just make sure whenever you are not convinced why any activity is happening in that phase, just come to me. And I recommend you to go ahead and start before reading your assignment, which is chapter 3 of Rita book. Okay. I want you just to do 2 or 3 trials of the Rita game. See with your existing knowledge right now, how are you performing in this? How many, just count out of the 92 cards, how many of the 92 cards you placed in the right place? Okay? Just make a checkpoint in your case. Okay? I mean, just see how much you are scoring. If you are scoring 92 out of 92, now you should be sitting in my place now teaching PMP. Okay? But for sure, you'll find a lot of crab. Okay? And I want you to discover that crab from now. Okay? The moment you discover it right now, you will focus on other crap to clear in the next lectures. So let's agree right now, in lecture 2, our scope is to clear as much crap as we have in our mindset. We need to really understand, okay, this is what I'm doing in the initiation. This is what I'm doing in the planning. This is what I'm doing in the execution. In the next lecture, we'll have more focus on the processes that are occurring in the initiation, in addition to 4 processes or 5 processes of the planning. So let's, you know, agree, gentlemen, that to focus on this and do the Rita game. Nobody should watch lecture 3 next week unless he scored 92 out of 92. If he scored 91, don't go to it, please. I'm telling you. Because you will tell me, Muhammad, difficult PMP. No, PMP is not difficult. You are the one who's making your life difficult by not listening to my instructions. If you want to be like Ala, scoring above target in all domains, please do whatever I ask you. If you don't do it, don't tell me you want to be like Ala. Do whatever I told you, you'll be... Maybe there is nothing above target, unfortunately, but I can guarantee you you'll be passing the exam with confidence. Just follow my instruction. Last thing, and I will tell you, خلاص, bye-bye. Okay? The last thing of our session. If you see here, if you go to our PMP story, okay, I did not really cover everything in the planning because many of you came to me already and they asked me, Muhammad, and I did not answer you for a reason. Many of you told me, Muhammad, in your PMP story, we didn't see quality management. We didn't see plan stakeholder management. Still, we believe that many things are missing in your chart. Yeah. Just keep in mind that my PMP story is there to simplify things. Okay. If you see here, I have already put in those missing items according to what? According to this one. Okay. So as you can see here, I have already marked those items that are missing from my story. especially when it comes to what? To my planning. Okay, as I said, after you place the 92 cards in the right place, your task later on to do what? To sequence these items in the right place. We need to make sure that we have healthy understanding, because most of the exam questions will ask you what you should do next, what you should do next. So you need to really have a sequence. You need to have, first of all, an understanding. Okay, the initiation items happening before planning, the planning happening before execution, etc. Then the planning, I need to know the sequence. This will strongly help you answer the exam questions that is always telling you what is going to happen next. What's going to happen next? So the moment you have that kind of sequence of understanding, you will be able to answer exam questions with confidence. So now let us just, you know, go over the sequence over here as per this. I mean, I just want to make your life easier, gentlemen, okay? So let's go over the sequence of the planning, okay? Because in the PMP story, we have already seen it clearly that in the planning, we have seen that we started with chapter 4 over here. Then we have our schedule management. So this is chapter 4. Then here we have chapter 6. Then here we have chapter 9. Then this is again chapter 6. You can see here I'm following the logic, okay? And I'm trying to tell you that, yes, we need to follow the same sequence, okay? Then we have again chapter 6. Then we have here chapter what? This is chapter 7. Then risk management is chapter 11. Then chapter 4. Chapter 4. Chapter 4. We have a mix of this, but now we are focusing on only what? On our planning processes. So let's just, you know, go quickly on those items that we have missed. The first thing you need to do is to do what? To determine your development life cycle. To tell, depending on the uncertainty level, will I go with agile or plan driven or hybrid? This is the first thing you need to decide in the beginning of your planning process group. Which life cycle I want? Remember, this is the first milestone that we have cleared. Which process? And as I said, there is no item better than the other. Depending on the uncertainty you have in your project, you will decide whether to go with agile, plan-driven, or hybrid. After that, we have already said that we will collect the requirements. The moment we collect the requirements, we will do what? We'll define our scope, okay? Then we have scope management. We'll enter here, okay? Some of you will ask this question, Muhammad, you didn't put procurement in your PMP story. Yeah, now you can see here, I have already incorporated some of this, you know? So if you see here, small, decide what to procure, okay? Which is happening what after your defined scope. So we are not talking about something that's different than our PMP story. We are just, you know, incorporating more information to our PMP story now, okay? So again, if we go to our, so here, the moment I collect my requirements and I define my scope, what I will do, I will assess what kind of procurement I need to have in place. Because the moment I collect the requirements and I define my scope, I will have an understanding of my capabilities as the buyer. Okay, I'm Saudi Aramco. I require this kind of technology that I don't have at the moment. And I don't have that expertise of expert judgment. So I need to outsource those equipment, those resources from a third party. That's why you will assess what to purchase. You need to decide from now what kind of things you need to purchase in terms of resources, in terms of technology, to be able to comply with what? With your scope. Because your scope will tell you how complex your project and how capable you are to do that kind of scope with your, let's say, in-house resources and equipment. And then you'll be able to decide what to procure, what to outsource. After that, I will decide what my planning team. Because again, I need expert judgment to help me estimate my activities later on. maybe I don't have the expertise that I need. That's why I will determine my planning team. I need to decide what expertise I require to estimate my project. Okay. After that, I will create my WBS, which we have already. I'll break down that scope statement to manageable pieces so I can have more clarity. So I can estimate. Okay. So the moment I define my WBS and WBS dictionary will cover it later on, inshallah, in the next session. So I'll not discuss it more here. We'll define our activities that are needed to produce the work packages. Then we'll sequence the activities. Okay. After that, we'll estimate the resources, as we said in the PIMP story. Because I have now understanding of the complexity, then I'll estimate the resources. After I estimate my resources, I will estimate my activity durations and what activity durations and cost. So this is going to be the next, duration and cost. After that, what I will do, I will determine my critical path. Some of you will ask, Muhammad, what is the critical path? If you go back to our story, so the moment you finish this kind of cycle, you'll have what? As you can see here, your critical path, which is the period you will need to take without having float. And we'll discuss this in more details in schedule management. So this is, you'll determine your critical path before what? Your schedule. Next, after I define my schedule, after I put my critical path, then I will have my schedule and then my budget. After my budget, I will do what? I will have my quality requirements. Okay. This my requirements will come after I have developed my budget. So here I have my quality. After I have my quality, I will have what? The rules and responsibilities. I need to define what's the rules and responsibilities of my resources. Okay? Because I have already know my project management team, my PID. Now is the time to know the rules and responsibilities. The moment I know the rules and responsibilities, now I know, okay, this guy needs this information, this guy needs this information, so I can plan what? The communication and stakeholder engagement, which is the next item. So after defining the rules and responsibilities, I will plan my communication and stakeholder engagement. After that, I will do my risk management. As I said, in the risk management, what I will do, I will iterate. I will go back again and refine my estimates. That's why you have here what? Go back, iterations. So whatever you do over here, you'll go back to your estimates to make those changes that are required. Okay? That's why we call it iterative. I will reuse those processes until I develop a realistic plan. That's what it means to have an iterative processes. Okay. Once I finish my iteration, I have a realistic plan. Now is the time to finalize my procurement. You will find this later on, you know, depending on the scope, depending on how my scope is defined, I will decide the type of contract I need to go with. Do I need to go with lump sum contract? Fixed price contract or work unit rate contract or cost reimbursable type of contract. Again, I will finalize this because خلاص, in here I have a realistic. I have already done my risk management. So now I have realistic plans. So now I can go ahead and do what? Finalize my procurement and determine my strategy, whether fixed price contract, lump sum, work unit rate contract whatsoever, which will be covered in more details in procurement management. After that, I will do what? I will create my change management plan. There should be a plan in place to control the changes. We have change management plan and we have configuration management plan. Muhammad, configuration management plan is Chinese. We'll cover this in the next lecture, okay? Don't worry. After that, I will finalize all management plans. Then I will develop realistic and sufficient project management plan and baselines. Then I will gain formal approval of that. After that, I will have my kickoff meeting. خلاص, green light, everything is okay. Then I will have my change request. This is just to emphasize what? here is my checkpoint. Before this, I am very kind. You can do whatever changes you want, okay? You can do whatever changes you want without any change management system, okay? After that, change request. Nothing will be accepted without change request. We have also Superman Ala is here. So just say yes, this is important. Tell them, yeah. So if you go to Ala, he will tell you how many questions he received just from this part. You know, how many questions he just received from this part over here. Very important. Don't overlook it. Pay attention to it, okay? And inshallah, by the end of this homework that you will do over here, you will be able to visualize this kind of misunderstanding that many people have, okay? So again, we have already covered whatever we want to cover in our session. We have covered our two milestones. Let's just do a recap of what we have covered so far. So we have covered two things over here, our project life cycle, as well as what? Our project management processes. And we understood that my project life cycle is how I'm going to develop my product. Will I use plan-driven approach, change-driven approach, or hybrid approach, depending on the uncertainty level available in the project. And it's the first item in what? In your planning column. You will decide that in the first phase, okay? After that, you will go and you will see how you will manage the development of your project, which is about all about what? The 49 processes, which will be covered in lecture 3 to lecture 7, okay? Currently, the scope of lecture 2 is to understand what? The 5 process groups. What are the items that are covered in here? What are the items that are covered here, 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 and here? I don't want people to mix between what is happening here to what's happening here. Rita game is the way to clear that. Make sure you score 92 out of 92. Play it 10 times, 20 times. It is free of charge. Nobody's going to ask you to pay a single real to play it. So play it 1,000 times. No worries. The more time you play it, the more confident you will be. Okay? And you, this is only your chance to have a more engaging session, inshallah, in the future. Now I finish my lecture. Those who fall asleep, don't worry. I know how important the information I have given this lecture. That's why I'm not going to be a person who's jealous. I will share with you the video of this session. Only this session. Don't come to me later on telling me, Muhammad, I want the YouTube link for the other sessions. I am sharing with you the link of this YouTube link for this session because I know the importance of the material that is covered in our session. That's why I'm going to share with you the link. In the future lectures, I will not share just to make sure that we have the commitment of you guys. Okay? That's why now we have 55. I want to see 55 people available in lecture number 7 as well. Okay? We want to see the same number. That's why I want you to attend with me the live sessions to hear your questions. Now, Muhammad, you are talkative, too much talking. Now is the time to shut my mouth and start, listening to your questions. So let me just take this off. Let's see now your questions before we say bye-bye. I just want to see your hands. Go ahead, in case you have any kind of questions. Wasim Mumin. Okay, Wasim. Yeah, go ahead.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
I want to know who actually develops the charter and whose approval is needed for the charter.
Very good question. It's good that you ask this question right now, okay? Look. The responsibility of the charter is really the sponsor. The sponsor, he's the person with his team who is responsible for the development of the charter. The BA is a key member of what? Of the charter development, okay? Because again, the PM during the charter development, his name is the BA. His name is not a project manager. The moment the charter is signed, his name will be converted from a BA, from a business analysis, to a project manager, okay? So again, to answer your question, the person who's in charge of this charter is the sponsor and his team. And he can delegate this job to whom? To the BA, who could be the future PM by the signature of the charter.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Welcome. Okay. I believe we should have a lot of questions right now, okay? So just, you know, if you have any kind of questions, please feel free to ask. I don't know if, for those whomever, I don't have really the time to go over the chat. So we have Ali Al-Jaziri. Let me just unmute Ali. Yeah, just go ahead, Ali.
Hi, how are you?
Hayakallah, Ali.
Just I want to know the difference between the process which we have in the PM book and the process which we have in Rita game. So even the number is different.
Very excellent questions. You know, currently we don't care about the Chinese names of the processes. Okay, so it's true that you have 49 processes, but inshallah in the lecture that we have on Wednesday, okay, it's not a lecture, when we play the Rita game, we'll start classifying those items under which process. So let me just, you know, just to make it clear to you, let me just share the screen, okay? So just to make the idea clear to everyone. So again, to go back to your question, you were saying, Muhammad, here we have how many? We have 40,
92.
No, you have 92, right?
Yeah.
92, right? And in this chart, which is the this one, which is the processes, we have how many? 49, right? Yeah. And in our Wednesday session that we will have together, what we will do, we'll go over these items over here, and we'll start classifying. This is part of 4.1. This is 4.1. This 4.1. This 4.1. So many items are under one process, okay? So we'll start classifying those, the 92, and the process itself, okay? So we'll tell you, okay, this 41.4.1, 4.1, 4.1, 4.1, this is 13.1, okay? So we'll start, you know, relating those nice names that you are familiar with the Chinese process names, okay? That's why our session on Wednesday could be 2 hours, could be 2 hours and a half, I don't know. What I care, those people who are sit with me, it will be like, we'll have like, you know, a laser in my mind. Muhammad, declare all the information you have in your mind, you know. This is what is going to happen in our PMP, story later on. So I hope this answered your question.
Okay, thank you so much.
Welcome, Habibi. Okay, let's go to Abdulaziz Babker. Yes.
Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
Muhammad, I have a little bit detailed question. In the planning, we have two changes. Create change and configuration management plan, and also request changes. What are the difference between them? And just in quick, I know you will describe this.
Just to make sure that I understood your question. So we are saying let me just, you know, show you the screen. So I just make sure that everyone understand your question. So what we are saying that we have here in the planning column, we have this create change management plan, and you have here request changes. So you are saying, what's the difference between these two? Is this your question?
Yes, correct.
Here you are putting the guidelines. So in this one, you have the guidelines. So you don't want people to be subjective in the way they do the change management stuff. So whenever any person in the company requests a change, he should follow these guidelines. So that's why you are developing here what? If you go here, create change management plan. This is the first plan, okay? The second thing is what? To create what? Configuration management plan, Okay, so we are creating two plans over here, the change management plan and the configuration management plan. And these are the guidelines to make the conduction of the process objective. When you go and you say request changes, this is just to help you understand that the processes available in the planning are iterative, which means that I will reuse them later on. Even during the execution, there is a chance that I will reuse some of the planning processes in the execution phase. Okay? So there is one thing, you know, that I had put for you as a part of your homework, which is what? It is here. I call it what? The project management process group checkpoints. Okay? So here, to answer the question, you said why there is change request, right? In the planning column. If you go to the planning one, this is telling you the reasons why you are entering what? The project planning. And one of them is what? Because of what? If you can see here, project monitoring and controlling necessitates additional planning, which means that when I was executing my job, I raised the change request. PID said, no, you need to redline the drawing. You need to make changes. That's why there is a change request. I'm going to make some changes to my plan during the execution or during the monitoring controlling process. Okay? So just make sure later on you study, go over this. This is telling you the different reasons why I'm going to enter, why I'm going to use my initiation processes, which are two. And this one, you are seeing the different reasons why I'm going to use my planning processes, which are 24 processes. Okay, and here you are having the different reasons why I'm going to use my execution processes, which are 10 processes. Okay, same with the monitoring control. What are the different reasons I'm going to use what? My monitoring controlling processes, which are what? 12. And the outcomes of this, it will impact what exactly? Part of the project. And ultimately, you have the project. What are the different reasons you will use the closing process? Either because your project phase is complete, that's why you will go to the closing phase, or because your project is complete, so either because of the phase is complete or the project is complete, or because your project is complete, is terminated, no, it's not no longer used. Okay? So again, change request is there to indicate that there is a high chance you will reuse the planning processes in other phases of the project, okay? While change management plan is a guideline. Ah.
Okay.
It seems you still did not get the
point.
Thank you, Mohammed.
Akid? No, I get it, yes. But I am thinking also about another question now. Also in the planning. We have a create activities list and a network diagram. The diagram only to like separate them or put it in like in certain order, because we have also activities list. So are they the same or they're different?
Are you talking about the activity list and the network diagram?
Yes.
This, when you talk about the activity list, you are just listing the activities without putting any logical sequence. I just need to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to complete that work package, okay? And the network diagram, I'm putting the logic sequence. So the logical sequence will be there. So I will do, okay, this one is there, this one should be here. So I'm putting here the logical sequence.
Okay, it's clear. Thank you, Mohammed. Thank you.
But in mind that no item in the planning was putting there to make your life harder. It is there for a reason. So excellent question. Always ask why. Be like the kid who always ask why 10 times until he find his answer. Okay, Buyad. Do we have any other question? Just feel free to ask. So I'm not sure if you have questions. We have Muslim. Okay, Muslim, just go ahead.
Assalamu alaikum, Ya Muhammad. I already went through this chapter. Is confused, which I think you will be able to.
Okay, could you please repeat, because I couldn't hear you.
Yeah, I went through the chapter, the process group chapter, okay? There is this activity, estimate resource requirement. It just comes after create network diagram. But in Rita's chapter, where it is asking us regarding the planning exercise. Okay, what are the specific actions required to complete project planning? In that sequence, estimate activity resources comes after plan resource management. That means we have already developed our budget, then we are estimate activity resources in the exercise of Rita chapter on page number 91. Okay, so this is the confusion. In the process chart, it is showing that estimate resource requirement is coming after create network diagram. But in the exercise, it is showing estimate activity resources is coming after plan resource management.
Which item is it? Because I'm already opening the page.
Okay. On process chart, it is estimate resource requirement, right?
Yeah, estimate resource requirement, which is item what in the in this?
Just coming after and in Rita's chapter there is an exercise, okay?
Yeah, which is already in front of you right now. So which item you're talking about?
I'm talking about estimate activity resource management chapter, page number 91, and the item is, I think, on the page it is number 4 item, estimate activity resources.
So this is page 91.
Yes.
So you are talking about here, right? So so you are talking about this refine.
Yeah, 91 of Rita.
But
No. Go on the top. Go on the top. 91. Go on the top.
Yeah.
There is estimate activity resources. The sequence is this one exactly. Okay, it is coming after the budget.
I'm telling you, don't confuse yourself with this, okay? Because the author, when he put this one over here, he's telling you, look, my friend, sorry, again, he don't want you to simply list this, you know? So don't just, you know, and have the understanding of the process names, okay? You need to have more than the names of the processes, okay? So he's not really there to tell you this is the right sequence. He's just there to tell you, if you know the names of the processes, it doesn't mean you are confident enough to pass the exam for the planning phase. You need to go over this, how many? This 44 items, okay? So what you should really follow is the 44 items, okay? Don't care about it's just a process names over here. So don't confuse yourself. Make sure that you really understand the sequence of those 44 items.
Okay, thank you, Muhammad.
Welcome, Habib.
Go with the process chart sequence, not this sequence.
Yeah, this is just the names. I can list you the names, but the names, they have too many breakdowns that I hope you got it.
Okay, thank you, Muhammad.
Welcome, Habibi. Okay, any more questions? It seems we have people who are shy, who are maybe using the... who are using the chat. If you have any kind of question, just go ahead and ask in front of us. So I will just count 1, 2, 3, 4. Amar, ask. Okay, yalla. Go ahead, Amar. Yes, Amar.
Good evening.
Good evening, yalla, Amar. Yes.
Muhammad, in the Rita chart, you put a marker, red star, in planning process.
Yes.
Why?
Red star? I'm just making your life easy, just to indicate what are the items that I have not included in my PMP story. So if you go to my PIM story, it is not really a comprehensive story that provides you all the details. It is missing some information. I have designed myself the PIM story to simplify things. I can simply put for you everything as per the Rita chart. But you say, Muhammad, you did not simplify it. You are just making my life harder. Okay? No, I want to make your life easier, but I want to put the details at the right time. So when I put the star, it's just to indicate the items that are part of the planning, but I did not cover myself in the planning in my PMP story for the sake of simplicity.
What about the others without star?
Without star, because really planning is one of the major, is the difficult part in the exam, okay? And tomorrow, in Wednesday session, okay, you'll have full understanding of the other columns. Now, the reason why I have indicated a star in the planning, okay, and I did not put for the others. Yeah, just
because... I'm asking about planning, Muhammad. In planning, there is some process without star, without red.
Because they are available in the PMP story already. So, for example, estimate resources is already available there.
Thank you, clear.
Welcome, Habibi. Okay. Yalla, let us see again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We have Hussam Muhsin, yalla. Yes, Hussam. Allah afik.
About the Rita game, you said we have 92 cards.
Yes.
It's all about planning or the whole...
No, Rita game is about from the start of the story to the end of the story. For all, initiation, planning, execution, closing. But in the planning, you need to put it in sequence. So the moment you place all 92 cards in the right column, then the last task you will be required to do is to place the items, the cards that are in the planning in the right sequence.
So we have to do it before Wednesday? All the 92...
Well, you can do it right now because it is for free. You can play it before you go home just to see how you are doing, okay? So you can do it as many times as you can. This is my recommendation, that you do it before you read, so you'll have a lot of question marks that will be answered by your reading task, okay? It's always good to have a lot. Why, for example, I'm evaluating the bids and the execution? Why I'm not doing it in the planning, for example? So the moment you start reading, you start saying, I want you to have a lot of aha moments when you read, okay? So I recommend you start with the Rita game. Play it. See the corruption.
Yani chapter 3 for all, not just only for planning.
Yeah, it's for all. That's why I told you it's an infrastructure, okay? Starting from next week, we'll start clearing the initiation and planning. We'll start clearing the 49 processes starting next week, inshallah.
Okay, inshallah. Thank you.
Welcome, Habibi. Okay. Any more questions? خلاص حسام محسن finish. Let's see if we don't have any further questions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. خلاص finish the time. The time is out. Okay, have a good night and see you inshallah on Wednesday night. Take care and have a good night. Bye bye.